I'm back. You thought I disappeared. I have not disappeared. I've come back. I've come back with new treatments and new technologies, and the whole pandemic thing has reset the whole healthcare system. It has reset technologies to help you for depression, which is in one of my channels called transcranial magnetic stimulation. But interesting enough, how does the pandemic affect what I'm talking about? It's very interesting. One of the things that seems to be resurfacing again is we call health spas. These health spas seem to be providing intravenous vitamin therapies. Now, this is going to be a topic in the next few weeks where I'll be providing different stages of how these nutrients work. You need to get a little background on vitamins. Vitamins in the 1940s, at that time, the Food and Drug Administration, which may or may not have been the same agency, decided to come up with certain amounts of vitamins that were needed so you didn't have deficiencies. It didn't tell you cures. The problem is that these vitamins, because they don't have no pharmaceutical ownership, and if nobody owns them, there's no incentive to do research if they actually can provide cure. So this was kind of left over the years to fly away as either hoax or snake oil, but we learned a lot. Back in the 1970s and 1980s, a field of orthomolecular psychiatry began to be born. It was formed by Linus Pauling, which I will give you some information in a future video. Linus Pauling was a award-winning, Nobel Prize-winning, where he actually elucidated the alpha helix of protein. He was a well-respected, well-known, and well-respected scientist until he came with the realization that a vitamin NAD, niacinic acid, nicotinamide, seemed to cure schizophrenia. This obviously created a great deal of fear among the pharmaceuticals, among established physician. He actually wrote a book called Orthomolecular Psychiatry. So basically, he promoted that certain vitamins, including vitamin C, had certain benefits. Eventually, he was challenged. There was no internet at that time, so he couldn't, there was no way of getting all this information. Eventually, faded away and died. However, during the pandemic, something incredible happened. We started learning that during the pandemic, people who had vitamin D levels who were at a certain amount seemed to have low illness rates or low morbidity or even no infections. This kind of woke up the mind of a lot of people. They also found like elements like zinc and other nutrients seemed to benefit people. And we said, wait a minute, how can that be? How can vitamins actually help people from a very severe illness? This broke up the medical community into 50-50. Some of us began to look into these products, into these alternatives, and guess what happened? A lot of now what they call health spas have surfaced with really valid information and valid nutritional supplements, which I will go into detail each one at a time. It appears that there's a lot of research as to the benefit of some of these nutritional supplements such as glutathione, NAD, vitamin C, but not at the subtherapeutic quantities, but rather a higher levels of administration. This is just an introduction. I will get into details. So this is just an introduction to let you know that in the future, I'm going to be discussing the benefits and potential treatments of certain illnesses of vitamins. Yes, this is going to create a lot of attention in the medical community for those who are watching, but there's a lot of valid research as to the benefit of certain nutrients. So stand by, and soon I will talk to you in more detail.